إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، فيا عباد الله، أوصي نفسي وإياكم، أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله عز وجل، فهو اللباس الذي يحبه الله، ولباس التقوى ذلك خير. ويقول الله عز وجل في محكم تنزيله: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. إخواني ويا أحبابي، الموضوع الذي أحببت أن نتناول في هذه الخطبة من أهمية المسلم، ألا وهو ذكر الله عز وجل، أن يذكر الله عز وجل في كل وقت وحين، وأن يكون من الذين قال الله عنهم: والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات. أسأل الله تبارك وتعالى أن يجعلنا من الذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تجعلنا ممن يتبعون هدايتك، حتى نكون من الذين يقولوا عندما يدخلون الجنة: الحمد لله الذي صدقنا وعده وأورثنا الأرض نتبوأ من الجنة حيث نشاء فنعم أجر العاملين. My respected brothers and sisters in Islam, from the greatest of acts of worship that a person can be accustomed to, from the greatest of ibadah that a person can get accustomed to, and from the greatest of circumstances that a person can find himself in, is at the time when he's remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَبِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ يَتَقَرَّبُ الْعَبْدُ إِلَى مَوْلَاهِ. With the remembrance of Allah, the servant gets closer to Allah جل وعلا. وَبِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ يَبْتَعِدُ الْعَبْدُ عَنْ كُلِّ خَطِيئَةٍ أَلَّتِي تُؤَدِّي إِلَى سَخَطِ اللَّهِ. And with the remembrance of Allah, the servant is able to refrain from all that which can lead to the anger of Allah جل وعلا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Remember me and I'll remember you, and be of those that show gratitude. Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah, he put a ta'liq and a quotation on this ayah, and he says that the greatest circumstance that a person can find himself in is at the moment when he's remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how can that not be the case? When the Messenger alayhi salatu wa salam, he informed us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, أنا مع عبدي إذا ذكرني. I am with my servant if he remembers me. إذا ذكرني في نفسه ذكرته في نفسي. If he remembers me to himself, then I remember him to myself. وإذا ذكرني في ملأ ذكرته في ملأ الذي خير من الملأ خير من الملأ الذي ذكرني فيه. And if he mentions me in a gathering, then I mention him in a gathering far greater and better than the gathering he was in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he describes the characteristics of the believers in the Quran. After mentioning the traits and the characteristics of the Muslims, he says, وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ. From the believers are those, or the believers are those that remember Allah Azza wa Jalla in abundance, from the believing men and the believing women. And in the very same surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he commands the believers and he says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا. Oh, you have believed, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in abundance. And this is what differentiates between the true believers and the hypocrites and the non-believers. For the hypocrites, they also remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he describes the hypocrites and he says, ولا يذكرون الله إلا قليلا. They remember Allah but not in abundance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He describes the non-believers. And He mentions to us that they also remember Allah. فَإِذَا رَكِبُوا فِي الْفُلْكِ دَعَوُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ فَلَمَّا نَجَّاهُمْ إِلَى الْبَرِّ إِذَا هُمْ يُشْرِكُونَ. That the non-believers, when they are on the ships, or put it in any other occasion, when they are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the going gets tough, they call out to Allah in sincerity. But when they reach safety, they associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the difference between the hypocrites and the disbelievers and the true believers is that the true believers, they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in abundance. So the question remains, are we of those that remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in abundance? Are we of those that remember Allah at times of ease, when everything is going smooth and there is nothing bothering us? Is our tongue the tongue that remembers and gives shukr and gratitude to Allah Azza wa Jalla? Or are we of those that completely forget about Allah and perhaps only remember Allah when the going gets tough? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions to us in Surah Safat, the state of Yunus alayhi salam, when he was stuck in the belly of the whale and he calls out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the famous dua that we are all aware of. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. Allah Jalla wa Ala, He tells us in the surah, فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. If Yunus alayhi salam was not of those that used to glorify Allah when the time was at ease, and when he was at ease and the blessings of Allah were showering upon him, he would have remained in the belly of the whale until the day of resurrection. What saved him after the tawfiq of Allah is that he used to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in abundance. And we find that in the prophets as well. Allah Jalla wa Ala, He mentions to us in Surah Al-Anbiya, the prophets, when they called out to Allah Azza wa Jalla, Ayyub alayhi salam, wa Ayyub iznada rabba, anni masani al-dur. When Ayyub called out to Allah and he said, oh Allah, I've been afflicted with severe illness, fastajabna la. Allah said, we responded to him immediately. We responded to him. Wa Zakariya iznada rabba. When Zakariya calls out to Allah Azza wa Jalla, Rabbi la tadharni farda wa anta khayru al-warithin. Oh Allah, do not leave me without any offsprings. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He said, we responded to him. وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ يَحْيَى, and we gave him Yahya. وَذَنُّونَ, Yunus that we just mentioned. وَذَنُّونَ, when he called out to Allah Azza wa Jalla, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ, we responded to his call. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمْ, and we preserved him and we protected them from darkness. What did the prophets have in common? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions at the end, He says, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرْهَبًا. They used to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in abundance day and night. The angels who do not sin and transgress, and there's not a commandment except that they fulfill it. What did Allah Azza wa Jalla say about them? يُسَبِّحُونَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ لَا يَفْتُرُونَ. They glorify Allah day and night and they do not take a break from it. These are the angels. لَا يَعْصُونَ اللَّهَ مَا أَمَرَهُمْ. They do not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُمَرُونَ. And they do what they are commanded. These are the states of the angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tells us about the creation. يُسَبِّحُ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. That in the heavens and the earth they glorify Allah. سَبَّحَ لِلَّهِ, they glorified Allah in the past and they continue to glorify Allah Jalla wa Ala. So where are we when it comes to the creation of Allah? So where are we as we are also the creation of Allah? Are we of those that remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in times of ease and in times of difficult, so that the makhraj and the exiting and the blessings and the bounties of Allah can fall upon us? The Messenger alayhi salatu wa salam, he told us. He says to us, احفظِ الله يحفظك. Safeguard the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can safeguard you. Allah, the Messenger alayhi salatu wa salam, he told us, تعرف على الله في الرخاء يعرفك في الشدة. Recognize and glorify and mention and venerate Allah at times of ease, so that Allah Azza wa Jalla can be by your side when you truly need Allah, and we are in need of Allah in all circumstances. So how are we when it comes to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And what do we know of the remembrance of Allah? something that is easy on the tongue, easily doable, yet many fall short. Wallahu al-musta'an. The Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, he told us of a hadith that is truly powerful indeed for those that ponder over it. The Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, أَلَا أُخْبِرُكُمْ بِخَيْرِ أَعْمَالِكُمْ. Shall I not inform you of the best of actions that you can indulge in? وَأَرْفَعَهَا فِي دَرَجَاتِكُمْ. And it will raise you in ranks. وَأَزْكَاهَا عِنْدَ مَلِكِكُمْ. And it is the purest in the sight of your King Allah Jalla wa'ala. وَخَيْرٌ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِنْفَاقِ الذَّهَبِ وَالْفِضَّةِ. And it's far better for you than giving in gold and silver. وَكَنَبِيَ تُرَى. وَخَيْرٌ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْ تَلْقَوْ عَدُوَّكُمْ فَيَضْرِبُوا أَعْنَاقَكُمْ وَتَضْرِبُوا أَعْنَاقَهُمْ. And it's better for you than being in the midst of the battlefield where you strike the necks of your enemies and they strike your neck. In jihad, fighting for the sake of Allah. Should I not inform you of that which is greater than all of that I mentioned? The companion said, بَلَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Inform us. The Messenger alayhi salatu wa salam, he said, ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ. Remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the remembrance of Allah will give us the ability to indulge in all the acts of worship that we are or we should be able to do. With the remembrance of Allah, we will find it at ease. Thus we find that burdens do not fall on our shoulders and we don't find the acts of worship to be of burden except that our remembrance of Allah is deficient. We are unable to wake up in the middle of the prayer. We are unable to wake up for Salat al-Fajr. Except that our remembrance of Allah is deficient. We are unable to indulge in that which Allah Azza wa Jalla commanded us to do, except that our remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is deficient. And this is an answer that we can ask, or a question that we can ask ourselves. When was the last time that I remember Allah Azza wa Jalla? When was the last time I say subhanallah and I say it from the depth of my heart? Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. Kalimatan. خفيفتان على اللسان ثقيلتان في الميزان حبيبتان إلى الرحمن. The messenger told us two words, only two words. ثقيلتان في الميزان, heavy on the scale. حبيبتان إلى الرحمن, most beloved to Allah جل وعلا. خفيفتان على اللسان, easy on the tongue. If I was to ask the congregation to put your hand up, I'm sure majority will put their hand up because they've heard of this hadith. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi subhanallah al-azim. Those two words. What is it that prevents us from being of those that remember Allah in abundance? Not that we lack health, nor that we lack knowledge of this, nor that we lack time. But what we do lack is al-tawfiq, the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this can be attained by Allah Jalla. This can be attained through Allah only. So we ask Allah to grant us a tawfiq. نسأل الله جل وعلا أن يرزقنا التوفيق. اللهم آمين. There was one abid, a worshipper, that was struck with paralysis. And he would call out to Allah عز وجل bedridden. He can only move his tongue. And he would say, الحمد لله الذي عافاني مما ابتلى كثير من الناس. Praise be to Allah who has preserved me and protect me from that which he has afflicted many people with. Bedridden, unable to move, paralyzed, only his tongue. A man that was walking by, he heard this and he was shocked. يعني surely it should be I who should say this when I see you in this state. How can it be that you are saying this supplication? Then he says, Alhamdulillah الذي أعطاني لسانا ذاكرا وقلبا خاشعا وجسدا على البلاء راضيا. Praise be to Allah who has given me a tongue that remembers Allah. There are those that are very healthy. They sleep, they wake up, they eat, provisions come to them day and night. Yet they do not remember Allah and they don't show gratitude to Allah. So who is the one that is afflicted? The bedridden one or this one that is walking on the face of the earth? Wallahu al-musta'an. We ask Allah Jalla wa'ala that He makes us of those that make use of this virtue. For indeed it is virtuous. Indeed it is virtuous that you are a person that remembers Allah. Because you are in need of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How do you expect to survive on this world when there are fitan all around us? When your tongue and your heart is void from the remembrance of Allah, how can it be? Which is why the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام he said, مثل الذي يذكر ربه والذي لا يذكره كمثل الحي والميت. The one that remembers Allah and the one that doesn't remember Allah is like the living and the dead. It's like the living and the dead. And I will conclude with the hadith of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام where he says, لقيت إبراهيم ليلة أسري بي. I met Ibrahim عليه السلام on my night journey. I met the Prophet Ibrahim عليه السلام. فقال يا محمد أقرئ أمتك مني السلام. Pass to your ummah my salam, Ibrahim says to the Messenger عليه السلام. Give to your ummah my greetings. وأخبرهم and inform them أن الجنة طيبة التربة. And inform them that in Jannah the soil in Jannah is pure. عذبة الماء and the water in Jannah is pure and is sweet. وأنها قيعان is bottomless. وغراسها and that which will plant this soil of yours, we ask Allah to make us from the inhabitants of Jannah, is سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes us of those and listen to the reminder and ponder over it and implement it and turn it into action. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ الْعَظِيمَ لِي وَلَكُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا. الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد. My respected brothers and sisters in Islam, to conclude today's khutbah, I would like to leave a reminder to our brothers and sisters that are going back to their education. As we are now entering the موسم الدراسة, a new year, and this is the life. A year finishes and a new year enters. And it is vital that each and every single one of us that we equip ourselves with the wasiyah and the advice of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. فَكَانَ خَيْرُ الْوَاسِي. For he was the best of advisors. The Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he told us in a prophetic hadith, he says, احرص على ما ينفعك. Strive to that which will benefit you. استعن بالله ولا تعجز. Seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do not fall lazy and do not fall out. And if anything was to afflict you from that which could be of that which is bad, فَلَا تَقُلْ لَوْ. Do not say if only. If matters were this, then it would have been that. فَإِنَّ لَوْ تَفْتَحُ أَبْوَابَ الشَّيْطَانِ. For if, the word if only, it opens the doors of shaitan. We are believers, people that submit to the qadr and the decree of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Upon us is what? To strive hard in that which will benefit us. So as the years begin, strive to that which will benefit you and seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout the academic year. And any success that come your way, do not forget to link this success towards Allah Jalla wa Ala in gratitude. فَمَا مِنْ خَيْرٍ إِلَّا آتَاهُ اللَّهِ إِلَّا أَتَى مِنْ قِبَلِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. Except that he came from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Lest that you are like Qarun, who was given the world and what was in it. And he says, إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَى عِلْمٍ عِنْدِي. This is from my knowledge. I attained it from my own work and my hard work and my efforts. And the results for Qarun was what? فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ. The ground that he used to walk in arrogantly swallowed him by the permission of Allah Jalla wa Ala. The second advice to myself and to all my respected brothers and sisters is, look to who you befriend. فَصَاحِبُ سَاحِبُ. Indeed the companion will pull you. إِمَّا إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَإِمَّا إِلَى الشَّرِ. Either they will pull you to that which is great or that which is evil. Look to who you take your companions as. As the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام he told us, or Allah جل وعلا he told us, that there will be people that will be regretting on the day of judgment. From their regrets is, يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا. If only I did not take so and so as a companion. For be a person of intellect, of sound mind, and choose wisely who you see as a friend, as a companion. For on the day of judgment, when the people are permitted to Jannah and the people are permitted to Jahannam, the people of Jahannam, they will call out and they will say, if only I had a true companion If only I had a good friend that could intercede for me today. When they see that there are those that are being interceded for due to the companions that they had. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our endeavors a success. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide us with the best of rizq. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to place in our hearts contentment. أسأل الله جل وعلا أن يغفر لنا ذنوبنا كلها دقها وجلها سرها وعلانيتها. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم إنا نسألك بأسمائك الحسنى وصفاتك العلى أن ترزقنا علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا. عباد الله صلوا وسلموا على من أمركم بالصلاة. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. عباد الله قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.